nigga.
Like that. I said, hold on a second.
Nigga, Lulu really said, hold on, let me beat this board real quick.
Come on, because I thought I had beat this level, and I didn't. And now I'm tight. Hold on.
Oh, Hobbs a Slytherin head ass.
You guys see my Hogwarts character. She looked just like me.
Dang. That's
funny.
But I put three cuts on her eyebrows because she be trying to wild out. Here we go. This is how I do it. Excendio.
Are you doing spells?
No, I'm playing Harry Potter.
Oh, okay.
That's a spell. Excendio. Spells. let me save because I can't with y'all.
We were waiting patiently. What are you saying?
This is gonna take a minute.
Oh, okay. All right. If that's the case, then yeah.
Alright, cool. Let's save. We can put we can focus.
I have to get Pat back in here. Waiting on Mama Meg.
Mama Meg. So we all decided to wear white today, huh?
This is Skims blue.
That's a blue?
This is like a blue gray. Yeah.
All right.
Your shirt right now?
Yeah.
Hell nah.
That shit will break the internet. If you post that, I'm like, what color is this? That's that dress all over again.
Wait.
That's bright white.
This is blue gray.
That is white, Lulu.
This is definitely not white.
I want you to say it.
That's grit. Definitely it's grit color. White. It's a that shit look like grit. Savory grits.
I thought that's what you said. Did what? You say grit without an S?
Yeah, that shit look like it's grit color.
Who said that?
Tahir, savory grits.
It look like grit.
Why do it got to be about food, Tahir?
Uh-uh.
Like grit?
One grit.
One grit? One elaborate grit?
One grit, just one grit. Hey, let me ask y'all a question. Are y'all watching or have y'all watched the show Gangs of London?
We talked about this.
Oh, no, I heard that from you, right?
Is it good?
Yeah. Is it good? The other day.
Every fucking episode leaves you like, what the last 10 minutes of every episode is going to blow your fucking mind.
Wait, is that what y'all was talking about with the violence?
Yes.
What kind of violence are we talking about?
Yo, like American violence in a London show. I've never
American violence.
This may be the best
show. The mutilation.
What's American violence?
Like American action violence. Like
they be decapitating. They show it all.
This shit is. It's probably the best shit I've seen since The Wire.
They busted, had this dude's face busted open. He banged him on the head on the table, and they.
Yo. This might be the best show I've seen. It's a TV
show, Kanisha. How would it be real? He'd be in jail.
Hey, it's London. I don't know what they can get away with.
I've never seen a London show, a UK show, with this much violence in it, ever. Like, I've seen people get shot and beat up in UK shows. This show, nigga. This is.
Are you on season two?
I'm still on one. I'm Lou. When I tell you, this is what I watch when I go to the gym. This is what I watch when I go to the gym. So each episode is like an hour.
So you never watch it?
Nah, we did that already.
You set it back up, Pat. I can't. You think I'm just gonna miss it?
It's my birthday, Lou. You could have let it go. You could have let it go.
You could have, Lou.
Nope.
This is birthday.
I have, you know, in the last 10 days, I've been to the gym 7 days in the last 10 days.
Hey.
In the Sims world?
Wow. Okay, Luke. I'll take your disbelief and your hate. And I'm a few that with the gym. So don't even.
You see how he said that all fast? He really said ate a Slim Jim 7 out of 10 days.
God damn it.
I've been to 7-Eleven. 7 out of 10 days.
7 days.
Lou and Meg, you're no longer invited to my birthday party. And Lou, you can't come either. I don't need that negativity in my. You fucking up my aura. I got
that's what my daughter says every day. Well, then you can't come to my birthday. That's
yeah, you can't come to my birthday party. I don't need that type of negativity there.
Kanisha, but you paid for it.
That's what I told her. And I still can't.
You should be like, dang, it's canceled then.
So, her dad's throwing her a party too, so she don't give a fuck.
Oh wow, she with it. She got two parties. She got over on your ass.
She's never partied up.
I like when Kanisha's when she laughs internally, her breast shake. She was like,
"Don't yours do the same?"
No, my things bounce. Lulu, you talk like you got one titty longer than the other. Why are you so mad at people with nice titties?
You got nice titties. I am not mad. I am not mad at your nice titties.
You just got a tattoo under your little box ass titties. Why you getting so mad at me because I'm living my best life?
What you say about my titties?
They boxy as hell.
You look like, they not. They cute. Girl, your titties are cute. Don't let him talk about you.
You got two boxes of hamburger hamper titties.
Wait till I get my titties done. Wait till I get my titties done.
You don't even need them done. You don't need them done. They fit you perfectly.
Lego ass titties out of here.
Girl, you could do that with a push-up bra. Don't do that.
When I take the bra off, they still right here.
No. I've seen your boobs. They're great. Just leave him.
Patrick laughed a little bit too loud about these titties.
Damn, Lulu, to hear said you got the Amazon smile on your titties.
her titties look like late library.
Titties look like Sahir. You ain't never seen not near, not a nipple.
I know what hamburger hamper looks like, whether it's under a shirt or not. I know box titties when I see it.
Oh, girl, you had a few. I saw you. You took that little picture of your tattoo and was showing a little underboob.
I don't give a fuck. You hurt my feelings about my weight. I'm gonna hurt your feelings about your titties. Fuck that.
See, but mine's are true. Yours is
I'm false. I'm like, gonna get my lick back.
Lulu, Tahir has had to picture women naked for his whole life. He's like, I know what she looks like naked, probably.
Hey, you said
what if Sahir just looks at himself and be like, maybe a little bit like this?
He just pictures the woman's face on his body, like, ugh, man, I don't like
man,
that.
Man, you have to imagine what women's titties look like too. You your big back ass. Pat getting dropped off by his nigga back to the airport.
Oh my God.
You're the finest women on the planet, like Halle Berry. Ugh, look at those freckled titties.
This nigga passing in the front seat like he ain't put out this weekend. That nigga driving that car like, this nigga had me fly him out for nothing. You got 36 side eyes since y'all left the hotel, nigga. This is why you said
that. Look at all this greenery. Look at all that greenery.
Are you guys flown out to, boo?
No, look at all this greenery. When Tahir gets flown out, it's only farmland.
Because they farm out to work. They like, we need extra bacon, stat.
I'm flying out to work, though. Are
terrible.
We need you at our stable, stat. Why? Nah, we just have extra feed.
Our plow broke. We need you, stat.
We got three extra orders of feed. We need help with the balance.
If they fly me out, they flying Lulu big forehead ass out. Her forehead like a mixing bowl. They gotta cook something.
They flew to here to curb a rodent part problem. We got rats all through here.
They flew me out to chase you away, redhead ass boy.
The fucking stray cats are. We haven't seen any stray cats in over a month. To hear, we need you.
Hey, I got a barber that can clean your mustache up.
No, don't go on that. No.
Your mustache is like Pat. A weed control, nigga.
Pat, pan your phone to the left so we can see your boyfriend.
Now you know Pan, all hey, Pat's niggas make Meg, him sign the NDA.
Meg, pan the camera left and right so we can see your husband.
Bye-bye me.
He got one of those.
You turn the camera off before she do that.
This is why I don't roast, because I don't want to get got.
This is all good, girl.
It's all good.
Oh, shit.
Sticks and stones, girl. Sticks and stones, okay?
Golly, I was not expecting. Lulu started it. Lulu came in with the bad energy.
I don't be starting nothing.
You started that, Lou.
You did.
I came to my tribe for positivity about going to
the gym. I think they'll say trough. I came to my trough for...
Low key, I think Lulu pissed everybody else when she tried to say her shirt was blue. It was all downhill from there.
It's blue gray. I'm telling you.
I'm tracking my miles.
Look at it.
This is me tracking. I'm doing 30 miles a month. You niggas tried to come for me.
In Uber? Are you tracking your Uber drives? That's what you're doing?
Lulu, you get fitted for your bras with a protractor.
Oh, that's 30 miles of hamster wheel.
it's still 30 miles to here. Don't worry about how you get it in. Don't let them try to steal your joy. Still, you still got 30 miles on your hamster wheel.
It's gotta jump off the old wheel.
It still counts.
There you go.
Goes like this. how do you find your post with no neck?
Hey, what matching set did you get for Valentine's Day? Is it the crossless one?
The crop top?
This nigga Pat came to the beach in a crotchless swimsuit. I was like, hey man, get the fuck back in the car, bro. The fuck are you doing?
Yeah, you know you like a crotchless swimsuit. Don't even front. With your satin robe to match. Don't even front.
Oh, that is funny.
Look at Kanisha. Kanisha's like, mm-mm. Not
up. Kanisha looks like somebody who don't want to jump in a fight because she got a gun on her.
She's like, and a warrant. She got a gun and a warrant. I can't do this.
Look, this is about as good a time as any for us to jump into the first topic of the day. That's exactly what we're about to do. I want to give a special shout out to our special guest, Miss Kanisha Buss is in the house. Woo-woo! And then big shout out to the OG squad, Man Scoop, Patrick Cloud, Lulu Gonzalez. Up to hear more. We're about to jump into the first topic right after this.
This episode is sponsored by Blue Chew. Let's talk about sex, guys. Shouldn't you always be at your best? 2023 is the year to maximize your performance in the bedroom. Listen up, BlueChew.com. Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra, Cialis, and Levitra, but in chewable tablets and at the fraction of the cost. You can take them anytime, day or night, so you can plan ahead or be ready when the opportunity arises. The process is simple. Sign up at BlueChew.com, consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you are approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. The best part? Yeah, it's all done online. So no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in line at the pharmacy. Blue Chew's tablets are made in the USA and prepared and shipped direct to your door in a discreet package. So don't be that guy that says, I don't need it. You never know until you try it. So look, Blue Chew wants to help you have better sex, all right? Discover your options at BlueChew.com, all right? Chew it and do it. And we have a special deal for our listeners. Try Blue Chew free when you use our promo code SQUADD, S-Q-U-A-D-D, at checkout. Just pay $5 for shipping. That's BlueChew.com. Promo code SQUADD, S-Q-U-A-D-D, to receive your first month free. Visit BlueChew.com for more details and more important safety information, all right? And we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring the podcast.
First topic of the day we have, would you rather have your ex as a therapist versus your mom as a wingman?
Oh, easy.
Oh, that's easy.
My mom is a great wing woman.
Yes.
Is she? My mama ain't.
Trust me, she want me to find a man just as bad as I do. She can't wait.
My mama would only be a good wingman for women that look like they know how to cook. She wouldn't go for the beverages that I would like. She would not be about it.
She know what good for you, okay? You want to eat them ham hocks every day? Okay, well, you need somebody who can make them.
Man. I don't see nothing wrong with that. You know, you, why you trying like you don't want a good brisket in the morning?
I mean, not every morning.
Those are the mornings you just get pussy. So it's a win-win.
Hilarious.
My mom don't know my style well enough for that.
My mom is me, but like more Asian. So she would be asking all type of like, all the questions that I would ask, and then some. So I actually like it. She'll be very thorough. I'll be okay with it.
You marry her. You are marry her.
Show my mother. Let me go show her.
I'm sorry, hated community. I couldn't help it. I'm sorry. You've been warmed up.
The whole community.
This nigga's wild.
I'm sorry. No. It's all Lulu's fault. Lulu said her shirt was blue.
And I'm sticking beside it. It's blue gray.
Shit, white is hell.
Okay, that is E-Crew. That is not.
It's bluish gray.
Big white. Big white.
You might have ordered that, but they
it's just the light that's making it look. It's blue gray. I'm telling you.
Oh Lord, we got that dress debate is back.
It's bad dope color. That should look like
bad dope.
Take a photo of it in the sunlight and post the question. Like, is this white clearly, or is this whatever you said, blue smoky?
Blue gray.
Blue gray.
Y'all don't know.
You took a picture and it looked exactly the same.
This light make it look white. It's not. I don't know what you
Was that the shirt on top of some boxes? What was that? Show the picture again.
don't listen to him. Happy birthday to here.
Is that that's USPS white?
Why? I'm gonna take a picture and post it, and it's clearly blue gray.
Hella engagement. But also, just because the website says blue gray doesn't necessarily make it blue gray on the spectrum. That is a white shirt.
That's what Kim Kardashian put, man. That's what she said.
Now. Well, listen, would none of y'all would have your ex as a therapist?
No, hell no. And what?
No.
What if she had a lot of good ratings on Yelp?
I don't trust them bitches.
No.
What? Therapists? No.
The people on Yelp.
Because therapists are still people and they still have biases. So no.
Exactly. Nah.
But therapists, they're bound by law. They can't do anything like that.
They can't have a bias. No, they can still have a bias.
You start addressing the shit they did and they try to flip it on you because now
they're gonna start giving you bad advice. No, I'm cool.
Right.
No.
They gotta coach you through your break up with them. So how did that make you feel?
This is not red table talk. I'm not here for it.
What did y'all do to y'all exes that y'all don't even want professional help from them?
I didn't do nothing. They are the ones that are fucked up. Why am I gonna seek help from their fucked up ass?
Okay, that's fair.
Well, I'm friends with my exes, but they don't need to be in my business. Me and my mom got dance routines, so we could definitely pick out.
Man, I'm only cool with one of my exes.
Me and my mom got dance routines, like to Usher. Yeah, we got a whole dance routine that we've been doing for years. So I would definitely let her be my wingman. Now she makes Usher,
the song. Yeah, bum 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 bum.
Yeah, we have a dance routine for that. So
Okay.
How it go?
Do the dance.
I'm in the club with my homies, and it's gonna be ya, and it come on up me.
Yes.
Feels. Hey,
get it, girl. Get it. I love it.
That was more complex than I thought.
You gotta make sure you hit the one, and that's the leg pop. It's four of those. It's dope.
Is your, how does your mom dance because she's white? Is she like down, like she's really good, or is it like
my mom, she dances down. You got to remember, my mom is her, the only white child. Both her brothers are black. My mom went to all black drama program, all black, everything. She's not, you know, she don't try to cultural appropriate. Her ass is white, but just with some flavor. So
okay.
She could dance. She used to write songs for Ice Cube and mail them to him when I was younger, like raps. Me and my mom battle rap. It's what? A lot.
Wait. Let's not glaze past that real quick. Did you say your mom used to write songs for Ice Cube and then mail them to her?
She would mail them. Now, he never did it, but my mom would sit up and write whole shit for Ice Cube and put it in the mail.
This makes so much sense about you, Kanisha. Like, the more I hear about your mother, I'm like, yeah, that's definitely Kanisha's mom. Yeah.
Yeah, she's a little off, but that's a. It's
Lulu, look at Lulu's
hard for social media.
Just imagine like my mom writing a hot 16, sending it to Ice Cube, like he gonna love this shit.
That's how it was.
Dear Mr. Cube, you don't know me, but you can use this in your next song. Kick it.
She did. She can rap.
What if he really used it one day? What was your mom gonna do?
I don't know. I was 12. I don't know.
Dear Mr. Cube is the word.
Oh shit! But yeah.
Did you ever walk in on her and she was like, "Get out! I'm writing for Cube."
No, but if you were at my baby shower, remember me and her was dancing to Both Thugs in Harmony. I'm about to post it now. We was getting
it. Wow. So I'm much.
I got bars.
You do.
That is.
Hey, what if there was a mailman that's been intercepting all those letters all these years, and he has a whole like mixtape series with your mom's bars?
He's been passing it off as his own.
Yes.
He's like, damn, I really miss when she used to write the Cube. I need a new mixtape.
I know she battled rap my baby father before. I mean, it's a lot.
You say she battle rapped who?
My baby's father before Bean's dad, because you know he's a rapper. So
wait, your mom battle rapped your baby daddy?
Yes. And I was like, Mom, please. She was like, Kanisha, shut the fuck up. I was like, all right, I'm done.
Hey, who won?
Let them battle. My mom.
Well, that's because the nigga couldn't be that disrespectful.
Well, of course. You know what I'm saying? But yeah.
That's hilarious. This makes so much sense. I don't think I would appreciate if your mom was just like a regular normal mom and you are who you are. This is good. This is good.
I'm definitely her child all day.
That is hilarious.
That's so funny.
Out the trash.
Sorry.
I can't imagine them like, whoa, cut the music. Let me wrap this fool out real quick. Everybody's at the baby shower like, what's happening?
Wait, it was at the baby shower?
No.
Hey, cut the music off.
There's a cipher.
The pacifier on the baby and shit. Wait, what? What's happening?
He did get off stage and sing.
Look, her mom's like, no, cut the music. I don't need no beat. Just let me get everybody to do this real quick.
Now everybody in the 313, put your motherfucking hands up and follow me.
No such thing as a halfway dance.
Oh shit. It just happened to be a talent manager there was like, this is what baby showers are missing.
Take a listen to this.
What are baby showers missing? If you said lyricism, you're correct.
It could have been. Motherfuckers was in the splits, twerking. My baby shower got a little out of hand.
Dude.
Your baby shower sponsored 4 baby showers after it. Everybody was there.
I know Kanisha was mad there was no liquor. She was.
I would smooth the fuck off.
The baby shower.
Man, was so mad.
Everybody had the Lulu. Everybody went to the store to get drunk. My mom had hers in her bag though, and forced us to get drunk. But that's another story. It was.
good times.
Oh my god. I missed that. Jesus.
It was the same day as Ron G's wedding, so a lot of people
it was split. Okay. That was good times. Well, let's put it to a vote. What we going with? We going with
I wasn't invited.
Who wasn't invited?
I wasn't invited, so I just went to where I was invited. So
oh, shit. Yeah. You was coming anyway.
I'm like, I'm gonna go.
Well, what we going with? We going with the ex as a therapist or the mom as a wingman?
Wingman, mama.
Mom is a wingman.
Yeah, that's probably the safest route. All right, well, wingman has it on that one. We're going to jump right into this next topic right after this. Next topic of the day we have, would you rather have a twin that you hate versus a disrespectful child?
We talking like
you just don't fuck with them at all.
Like at all?
At all.
But to the point where they were
weird. Like, how does that even happen? Y'all shared a womb.
It happens.
People fall out with their parents. You can fall out with a sibling.
But your twin, the one that looks exactly like you.
I mean, but they're also fraternal twins. You don't necessarily have to be identical.
Well, true, but I'm just saying.
Well, if it's identical, that changes stuff. Because if they hate you and they're identical to you, they could do mischievous stuff.
Exactly.
Okay, so that's a good point, Pat. So let's say fraternal twin. You have a fraternal twin that you hate or a disrespectful child. And I'm talking about this child is disrespectful out the gate. Like, at four or five, he's telling you, fuck you.
How long are they disrespectful?
They disrespectful child. Forever. Just... Y'all just
see, you can beat your child.
Because you can get in trouble. You could go. Let me, as someone who hates their actual siblings and does not speak to them and will never speak to them, and I have thrown hands, and you can't do that. You don't go to jail over that. So you can continue to beat your sibling ass every time you see them. You can't just be hitting on your child. And I think it's more hurtful because you gave birth to this child. This is my child. So then it's like, what did I do wrong?
Wait,
and
but what if it's the disrespectful child? He's saying like ultimate disrespect, never, ever, ever. Like...
So I would go with the sibling because the sibling, you don't have to deal with the sibling. Like, you know what? I'm not talking to you. You know what I'm saying? Right. A badass kid, that's hard. I wouldn't do that. It's your child. You would definitely pick not talking to your twin over your child. That's
I don't know, girl. I got two.
I see.
Sorry, Millie. Sorry, she ain't here. My bad. No, I feel you on that.
Disrespectful though. That's the thing.
Well, they can't really talk that well now. Only Mav could talk a little bit, but when they get old enough to talk, if Meg was like, eat your seaweed, they was like, fuck you, mom. Take this fucking abacus back. We like calculators over here.
Abacus?
You know what he does, though? That, like, he be something when I tell him, because I don't play. When I tell you to do something, do it. And then he, you know, kids be want to do whatever they want to do. And I'm like, all right, now, I already told you what. You know, I don't beat my child, but like he knows when he hears that voice. So lately, because he goes to school with the friends of a lighter shade, he done came home and told him he can't do something. He'd be like, ah! What? This is what your white friends do? Like, I don't know how am I supposed to respond?
You yell right back at him. See what happened.
Yeah.
The first time I just stood there, I was like, do I beat him? Like, what am I supposed to do?
Story yelling before he even finishes, story Joe yell. So he's like, like louder than him.
Yeah.
Just shut him down.
He's like a bear. That scared these little motherfuckers. Right?
Yeah. And knock them down when you do it. Really mean business. Like knock that bowl of seaweed down. It's like,
Knock the rice out of his head.
Ah. Throw that rice milk across the room.
Ah. Not the rice milk.
It's gonna be like, mom, son, so karasia.
You deliver
mom,
me?
Son?
Disobey.
Meg, son. You disrespected my dojo.
Oh my god.
Really? Two fingers.
Not the son.
Well, as one of the only non-parents here, I'm sure everybody's dying to hear what I have to say.
I'm not a parent either.
I said as one of the only. You are the only non-only. Huh?
No, I don't like how you worded that, but go ahead.
He said it correctly, Lou.
I just said one of the. I feel like a child is an extension of you. Like when a child is acting like crazy in public, people look at the parent like, but if your twin is acting crazy, they might look at you because you with him, but what he does or he or she does out in the like society isn't a reflection of you. It's just your family. So
yeah, I feel like his mama.
Right. So a disrespectful kid, I mean, you could just keep hitting them until they aren't disrespectful. But a twin, you could just get away from, you know?
You can't keep hitting them. That's the birth of a villain origin story right there.
That's not what y'all be doing?
No. My daughter has been popped maybe 3 times in her whole life. No.
Oh, I got popped in the mouth a lot.
How old is she?
You know, because I feel like we grew up with like abusive parents. I don't know. It's different when you parent in this day and age.
Oh,
I have not given my child nowhere near as many whoopings as I got.
The baby began to reassure you that she wasn't disrespectful. Like, let me go in here real quick and snuggle. I don't know what these motherfuckers talking about.
getting popped is an abuse.
You said what?
I don't think getting popped abuse.
No. According to the law, yes.
I don't think so.
I'll tell you this. One time, the kid got in trouble. Farron had disciplined her, right? And she got disciplined when she had on shorts. And so, you know, she was trying to, you know, move around. So, you know, you go a little longer when they're moving around, right? The next day when she went to school, she wore shorts. And so it was a welt on the leg, right? When I went to go pick her up from after school, them people don't say nothing to me. They smiled in my face and, oh, she's right here. She's such a great kid, all this type of stuff. I get home from picking up the kid. The cops are waiting for me. They had called the cops. Yes, they had called the cops. They walked us
before
in the
house. Before they saw you?
This is after I picked her up from after school program, right? So the after
school. But they
had
already called the cops when they saw you.
They called the cops at the beginning of after school. They said they told them what time we normally come pick her up, and they gave them our address. So once we got home, they were already there waiting for me. So when we get there, they's like, hey, are you such and such? I'm like, yeah, you know, what's up? Mind you, I wasn't even a person that disciplined, right? I just happened to be the nigga there. Bro, they take us in the apartment. They sit me down in the living room. They take the kid in the bedroom. They talking to the kid. I guess they asking like the normal questions. Do your parents hit you a lot? Do they hit you for nothing? Is it just because you did something? Or like they go through the whole gamut of questions. And the cop that's in the living room, he's talking to me. I ain't throw Farron under the bus, but he's just like, listen, man, I get it. You know, I discipline my kids too. You just got to make sure you discipline them to the point to where it's not leaving marks that causes suspicion or concern for their teachers and people that they interact with at school. Because if they do that by law, they're obligated to call us. He's like, nah, we're not trying to tell you how to discipline your child or not to discipline your child, but you just have to be mindful of how you discipline your child or where you discipline your child or how hard you discipline your child, because we will get a call and we will have to come out and this type of thing will happen. And that was the first time that's ever happened, the only time it's ever happened, but that shit had me shook. Them niggas was waiting.
Wow.
That's good. I'm glad.
But they just left her there? They didn't like do anything?
Yeah. They kids snitched. Yeah.
They could decipher what's going on, but if more stuff like that would happen, it'd be a lot of kids that was still here that have
that's
gone.
True.
So.
That's true.
That's
California is super liberal, and then where we stay at, they all about the kids. Like the community that we are in, the predominant race here is all about their kids. Like when I used to go pick the kid up from school, I would see like the dad would pull up with the mom. And when the kid comes over to the car, the mom would get out and get in the back seat so the kid could get in the front seat. Like their kids are everything to them here. The hierarchy is dad, kid, grandparents, other kids, like the kid they don't like, and then the mom. The mom is at the bottom of the totem pole.
That's what race is bro, this?
Bro. We know what it is.
That wouldn't be kids, though.
You know where I'm at, Meg.
Okay, yeah, okay.
If you sit in the front, that's more dangerous for the child, so they don't give a fuck about their child.
I really
that's probably like why the mom be like, yeah, go ahead and sit up there since I'm at the bottom of the ladder. Go ahead and sit in the front.
You gotta protect the one that can make more kids.
Yeah, they sit in the front, Jimmy.
Bro, I've seen it at restaurants. Like, I've seen the kid disrespect the mom. Like, shut up, mom. But they don't disrespect the dad, and the dad don't check them when they disrespect the mom either.
Crazy.
That's wild.
Crazy.
My mom would have brass knuckles on, putting on Vaseline on her face. You would think it was Creed 4. She'd be like, all right, let's get it.
And I think our generation and our parent, we're finding that middle ground, because a lot of us I got beat with extension cord. I mean, anything. You know what I'm saying? And white women are not even supposed to whoop their kids. So my white woman was broken. I was mad as shit. Like, all my other mixed friends wasn't getting whoopings, but me. I'm like,
my white woman broke.
her mom was having an identity crisis. Like, oh, I know I'm doing this, but
to beat the brakes off us. So we're trying to find that middle ground. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, you do need some, but the shit we was getting is not it. And being the reason why she ain't got popped again, we're at the school, right when I pick her up in front of because she's in private school, the director, she go, right when I get it. Remember when you popped me like this? And I'm sitting there looking at the lady, and the lady looking, yeah, remember you popped me? I peed on myself because she was potty training, and now it looks like I'm whooping her for peeing on herself, but they don't know that we just got off the toilet and she came and shit in the living room, so I popped her ass. She got her ass whooped, and she was like, "Yeah, Mary, you popped me." So
that was intentional. She knew what she was doing. B was trying to set you up for the okie doke.
These kids are wild. No, so my son is 4, and I just like there's this song on YouTube that's like it's like a boundary song. So basically, like it's like teaches kids tell people to stay away, you're too close to me, I don't like that touch, I don't like, you know, whatever, right? So I was like, oh, this is a good song for him to learn so he can sing this to somebody, you know, if it happens. Let me tell you, I almost had to pop him one day, and he gonna look at me, he goes, please stop, I don't like that, I'm feeling uncomfortable, I need more space. I said, that is not why I taught you that song.
And you gotta respect it, because that's
said, what, reverse back to you.
What creep are that gonna ward off?
He's little, so
a musical
sweet
kid. Please stop, don't put me in that van, I do not want to go in that van.
That's a great tactic. You never like, man, fuck this, I can't take this singing ass kid.
You got on me.
I'm telling you,
I don't like that. Like, wow. Okay. All right.
And you gotta respect it, because you're teaching them this stuff, and then they do it.
I was like, you're right. Let me give you your space, homie.
Vividly remembers telling me, and I remember it too. I was like 4 in Panama, and she said I would not stop acting up, that she went and bought a belt in the store, walked around and was on it on her shoulder, like, try me if you want to.
I believe it. I'm with your mom. I believe that shit.
So
she went and bought a belt just to prove her point. She's like, let me show you how committed I am.
Exactly. My mom's number one didn't have a belt. Is always, because she said she used to leave the house with something to whoop me. And she said, that day, I did not leave. She said, I went and bought a belt and put it. She's like, because her number one rule is, don't embarrass me in the street. Do not embarrass me. I'm going to embarrass you.
Oh, so, my mom loved it. My mom one time didn't have a belt. She used a seatbelt. She held me by the car, pulled the seatbelt out, and then looped it, and then hit me with that.
What if you kept getting stuck? Like, every time she got angry? Like,
yeah, you got to pull it all the way out. How did you do that? You got to pull it all the way out. You got to pull it all the way out.
But you know, when you jerk it too bad to get stuck, yeah.
If you pull it till it has no more slack, then just slide your hand down and use the extra that you have. Loot that shit.
Get going, Pat. It's right here.
It wasn't enough to like get me a real whooping, but it got me right here. She got me right there. It was solid. It was solid.
Well, Tahira has a very short upper body, so she didn't need that much. She probably just needed this much.
When Pat got in trouble, his parents stopped doing his hair, and you see it just kept just carried on.
Come on,
over.
Let me have that, bro.
Just carried on over. Look, Pat. Nigga, Pat just wake up with a messy bun. Just...
Hey, I actually got whipped by a conga.
You say what?
That's why I relate to my Afro Latinas because I got hit with a chancla.
You did?
Shout out to you, Lulu.
Who did that? Your mom or your dad?
My mom had a gray chancla with a red lining in it, and she was like Bruce Lee with that shit.
I can't imagine. I mean, other than being like curious, like what were you doing when you got in trouble?
Roasting. Just fighting with my brother. I was the good one though. My older siblings got in trouble, but I only got in trouble for fighting.
Only for fighting. Like, I remember fight. You know,
I can't even imagine Pat fighting for real. I saw Pat get mad one time.
He fight like this.
That was like, all right, he has it in him. He got a little dog.
I was so surprised because before I was like, oh. First time I ever thought, I was like, I could take Pat if I needed to. If it came down to we had to throw hands, I got him. That one time he was on set. Got
so mad. I never seen that nigga put his hair in a bun so fast.
I didn't do that. That's always part of the story.
That nigga put his hair in a bun. He tied his shirt up. He's like, what's up, motherfucker?
Who was he about to fight?
We was on set. What was these? Who was it?
It was the guy, so we had, this is when they were first doing Roast Me, I think, and we were doing it in that, like, that old place out there by, like, way out by the 110, like, I forgot
what. Oh, no, wait, no, this was the dance show, remember?
Oh, this was.
It was the dance show.
So it was the frustration of the dude who kept using the power tool, and then it was also the frustration of the show flopping. And Pat was like, I'm sick of this shit.
We were shooting it. It didn't flop yet.
You knew why you were shooting it. It wasn't going to
make it. It was telltale signs, nigga. It was definitely telltale signs.
I'm about to say, what show is this? I've never seen this show.
It did well on Facebook. Shut up.
Lulu, that shit hit 500 views. Russell came in. It was the first time Russell came into the computer. It was like, delete. Delete.
Hey, no one called that show a flop until I did. So
That was a fun show. Dance Break was a great show.
The studio was downtown in that building.
It wasn't. No, we went to another location. Town. We went to like this abandoned warehouse looking place to shoot that. And then the people next door was being a-holes, and Pat really was about to go square up. And I was like, shut up. So he might could take me in a fight.
That dude knew that we were filming and he was getting put out. So he was mad that he had to evacuate. So he was just trying to make it more difficult for us to film. And he knew that we would have to pay him to get him to stop. And that was the real reason he was doing it. So he calls the ruckus to get paid off.
Did you guys pay him?
We had to. That nigga wasn't going to stop. And we couldn't get Pat out. Pat had that dog in him, but he would not do. We couldn't let Pat go to jail for that shit. We was like,
yeah.
All right, so let's put it to a vote. Have a twin you hate versus a disrespectful child. What are we going with?
Twin.
All right. Twins are unanimous on that one. We're going to jump into this last topic right after this. Last topic of the day. We have, what is the better party starter? This is how we do it versus summertime.
This is how we do it.
Because
this is how we do it. Everybody start.
But wait. There's something to be said about summertime, though. Summertime is still a good vibe, though.
It only hits hard in the summertime.
You can't play that when it's cold.
It's a car summertime. Like, summertime, come on, and you in the car. That's the vibe for summertime.
Or a barbecue. That's it.
Or the barbecue.
Cookout, yeah.
Summer, it's always at a party.
Yeah. So I should have did, what's the better song? This is how we do it, or Before I Let Go.
Ooh. For the cookout?
It's two different generations.
Yeah, it is. Two different vibes.
It is, but if you put either one of them on at a black function, everybody's going to say that first part.
But I think we would all answer and say, this is how we do it, because that's our generation.
Mm. Yeah.
Man, it starts
off. Well, except for you to hear, you probably say the other one, because you civil rights era. But other than that, I think.
He's like five times.
Meg's the only one, maybe going to the club. She's like, you have anything from the Mulan soundtrack? You ain't got nothing.
Wait, when y'all go to the club or bar or whatever, and there's a DJ, if you have to, like, request a song, what's your go-to song that you would request?
Tahir be asking for, this is how we chew it.
I was out with Pat one time, and the DJ played Braid My Hair by Mario. That nigga knocked all the speakers down. That nigga went into the Tasmanian devil. He took the DJ's laptop and broke it over his knee. I was like, calm down, nigga. It's just a jested.
And no. then Tahir suggested, I got fries on it.
Can you add some nachos, please? I got fries on
it. That was such a good comeback. I don't even want to mess that up, nigga. I'm going to let that live. That was good, nigga.
Come on, let's go have more fries.
Wait, did you already have that one? Talk, because that one came out quick. It was so quick.
It was. I got fries on it.
Yuck Mouth just performed that at Boo's 50th birthday.
That's dope as hell, bro.
I'm mad I missed it.
The worlds are colliding now in entertainment. Like, don't get me wrong. Like social media has done... It's lifted the veil on a lot of shit. Some of your favorite artists and actors and just entertainers in general, you're like, ugh, that motherfucker really get down like that? But it's also been able to connect us with some of the people that we really admire, and just beautiful relationships have come from that. So I love that I saw them like that. That was dope. And Corey Holcomb was there. They was roasting. You saw new comics and old comics all just chilling together. That was a beautiful thing. I hate I was out of town for it, bro.
It was. We had a good time.
But what's y'all's go-to songs to request?
Big Pimpin', Jay-Z.
Oh, shit. Wait.
For a party?
Mine is... Yeah.
For a party. what's yours, Meg?
Mine is I Wish by Ski-Lo.
Hey, low-keto?
First of all...
Bob? That's so random.
Bob?
Summer Jam. They
have to take me
over to the tent because I damn near fainted at Summer Jam 93 over Ski-Lo, and I still know that whole song.
Ski-Lo, right? I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was
fainted over Ski-Lo?
No, I did. I wish I was like 6'9" so I could get with Lyoshi, because she don't know me, but Yoshi's really fine.
Oh, you know, I see him all the time, everywhere I go, and even in my dreams. 65 ways to make my mind.
Listen.
A boy this tall, he plays ball, so how am I going to compete with that? Because when it comes to
playing basketball,
I'm always last to be picked, and that's okay, so never pick it up. So I just laid up on the wall.
I streamed that at least once.
Dang, y'all, I never understood that.
Y'all sound really bad. Y'all sound really bad, just so you know. Like, it wasn't giving what y'all thought it was giving.
Doom was just hating on some real niggas.
They were finishing before
Kanisha, and I was looking at her and trying to wait for her. Like,
it wasn't giving what y'all thought it was.
Hey, in our heads, we was Summer Jam in 93.
We killed that. You know what? We're gonna do it tomorrow. We're gonna do it tomorrow, Kanisha.
All right. Oh,
I'm gonna have artistic play.
Yes.
The birthday, gonna be lit. Birthday
gonna be lit. I'm so sad. I'm gonna miss it to hear.
I hate that you ain't gonna be here. I'm actually kicking it off tonight.
I can't drink liquor anymore. Do you know how devastated I'm gonna be in there?
You can still be fun.
About to be for me.
Can you do edibles?
What time is it, the party?
Nine to two.
All right, cool. I got a show, but I'm gonna come by after.
Yep. I'm going out tonight too. If anybody wants to hang out, we're going to Motown on Mondays tonight.
What's that? Is that a comedy show?
No. It's like a lounge night at the Shortstop. They do it on Monday nights where they play like a lot of Motown music, old and new. The DJs mix it. It's like funk, R&B, hip hop, like old hip hop. It's a dope ass.
So like 60 and up.
No, everybody in there is young, Lulu.
You know what's funny? Like Pat wasn't at, when you said Motown money, he's like, what is that? He wasn't asking what that night was. He was asking what Motown was.
What Motown was.
Shut up. I went to music school. I know Stevie Wonder. Everybody in that lounge today is going to be spinning a pocket watch. Hey, what's up, Cat?
With a bowler hat with a feather in it? What time is it? Click, click. Click.
I thought you were really asking. I was going to give you the time tonight.
Oh, this clock is broken.
I hate it here, man. I hate it.
All for the spins. All for the spins.
All for the spins. And they got suspenders, so they got to be like, Oh, yeah.
Lulu, you almost caved your chest in with that strong-ass bra. You need to relax, okay? Your chest with the clothes like Michael's.
Bra. You should get one. I'm going to get you one for your birthday. I'm going to get you a Skims bra just for you with extra push.
They're going to get you a brown bra that say UPS.
Y'all,
they got a couple of them already. Big back.
Oh man,
Lulu, you hate visors, don't you?
You said what?
You hate visors, don't you?
I hate violence.
Visors.
Nice. You trying to say because I got you? We got the same big ass forehead, Tay. I don't know what you talking about.
Oh, we don't.
Yes, we do.
My shit look like a forehead. Yours is like a headlight.
Soon as that hairpiece come off, you got a five head. You is out there reaching.
Hey, do y'all got a forehead or a five head?
Measuring his head.
I have a three head.
I got forehead.
Lulu, you got three fingers.
Lulu, yeah, for my eyebrows.
Four.
Lulu, this is you, Lou. This is you.
You is a lie. You is a lie.
I got all five.
You is a lie.
Pull that hand down by your eyebrows and then show how much.
See, it should be three.
Start it here. Start it here.
Wait, do yours to here.
This is me.
Lulu, you're not using all the space.
Yes,
Lulu, you're not using all the space.
This is Lou, and she don't want to talk about it. Let's talk about it, Lou.
You got to cover everything.
Yeah, we got a forehead, Lou. You got a catcher's mitt head. You got
I don't know why you over here talking about her. Pat over here got six fingers on his forehead.
I started that. What are you talking about? I said I need all.
That's what I'm saying. He don't got to skip over you. No, don't skip past Pat. Pat got a cute. And the reason why Pat's forehead don't.
Man,
you look like you don't have a big forehead is because you let your new growth grow down, downwards.
How does new girl throw down?
Huh?
And that's gonna brush your baby hairs down, okay?
Yeah, please. You see that strong ass line? There ain't no baby's hairs over here. I'm good.
Take the Velcro off. Take the Velcro off. It's time.
You do it first on that box bra you got on. You got two goddamn milk cartons holding up your breasts.
And you damn right. They some juicy ass milk cartons.
No, they not. They crazy. They dirty crates.
Juicy. You wish you had the juice.
How you got juicy milk?
Because it's not from concentrate.
Let's put it to a vote. This is how we do it in the summertime.
To him, look like he got Tang in his bra. Can he go? You do. If I look at you and I saw your breasts, I'd be like, it's Tampico in there.
Well, you get a tip to here, spur a little tang in here.
I'm hey, I'm the barber let me, put let a me bucket on drink here this morning. At 7 a.m. Like,
bring your own alcohol because I got the mixer.
Meg, your kids keep talking back because you keep putting Fabuloso in their bottles. I told you to cut that shit out.
Nah, bro, don't even try it. It's your birthday roast today, okay?
You're walking around, don't milk. You wanna? Don't you wanna? Got Fanta titties. Shut up.
I wish I had
you got them box wine ass titties. You don't get
the you said that already. Do it again. We gotta get something else. Come on, man.
That's still good. Oh,
you better than this. Good. That's you still better good. Than this.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. What are you thinking? Anyway, listen, that's been another episode of SquaddCast Versus. Thank y'all so much for watching. We had a fantastic time with you. Shout out to our special guest, Kanisha Buss.
Wait, what voice. Was the topic?
We already voted. We all this said is this how is how we do it.
Oh, okay. Jesus I didn't realize Christ. You voted.
Stop drinking Fabuloso, nigga. Anyway, thank y'all so much for tuning in. Shout out to the OG squad, Meg Scoop, Patrick Cloud, Lulu Gonzalez, about to hear more. We'll see you next week on another episode of SquaddCast Versus. Peace, guys.
Give me some Tampico.